Now, when I first asked for your help, I was apprehensive. But you were just a bunch of kids.
We are.
The Irregulars is a very cool story about these sort of five kids who are not your typical superheroes or the people who are the typical heroes.
The Irregulars as a show is set in the Sherlock Holmes world slash universe. In the books, it's the Baker Street Gang. And it was this little street gang of kids who would come in and help Holmes and Watson with the cases. But we are essentially a version of that.
It's quite dark and it's quite gritty, but it's also really heartwarming.
Jessie and Bea are two sisters and they met Billy in the workhouse when they were kids. And I think that experience has bonded them together as a family. And they meet Spike and he becomes part of that family. It's very much them against the world. I think Jessie is Bea's driving force. Everything she does is to protect her and to look after her. Not that Jessie can't stand on her own.
Jessie, go back to the cellar with him.
What? No, I'm coming with you, I wanna help.
No, you're not.
You can't keep me cooped up all day because you're worried something might happen to me.
When we start the series, Jessie, everyone's worried about her. They think that she's sick. I mean, they're desperate to try and scrabble the money together to kind of make sure that she's gonna be okay. And I think Jessie feels like she's different, and I feel like that's a growing theme throughout the show, is that Jessie feels like she's not normal, and I think it really bothers her. She wants to come with you guys to solve the mysteries and be a part of that. We've been filming this mostly in Liverpool, which was completely jammy because when I went for this audition, I did not think that I was gonna get it because it was filming here and I live here. And I was like, this is too good to be true. This is never gonna happen. When all the guys came here, I was like, guys, I know all the stuff. I know everything. Like, come to me.
I thought it was filming in London. I got a text a few days before. So just talking about you're traveling up to Liverpool. I'm like, oh yeah. What's all this then? Victorian London, you say?
You beat up the whole police force.
Well, not all of them. I do like a quarter of them, and then the rest of them would shit themselves and back off.
Billy grew up in the workhouse, never knew his parents, but his dad was a war hero. And I think, although we never knew him and the guy was never on the scene, I think that's left him with a big set of shoes to fill, you know? And I think he feels that weight a lot.
When I first got sent the script, I
saw it and I was like, hang on a minute, why am I auditioning for Billy? I should be auditioning for this Spike guy. That seems way better. That seems way more fun. Like, Billy doesn't get to smile. Spike gets all the jokes. This is all wrong.
Can I just say, us walking away from peril, such a refreshing change of tack. This right here is the appropriate reaction to danger.
Spike is the cheeky, banterous chameleon, I'd say. And I think, well, he is the skeleton of the group. So I think without him, you guys would just fall apart. But I think his lightheartedness and his playfulness, his youthfulness brings a different quality to the gang. Whereas a lot of the stuff that we're going through is super sometimes depressing and dark. But I think he kind of has like a bright outlook to it. Everybody needs a Spike in their life. So if you're out there.
And Leo has come from a very privileged background. He's very different to the other Irregulars. With his situation and his family, he's sort of been kept away for a long period of time. And he asked to leave the palace and to go and see London. And that is where he encounters the Irregulars. Seeing these guys all be a family and be friends is exactly what he's always wanted. It's been his dream. And then he starts to realize, oh, this is actually a lot darker and a lot trickier than I... Is this what all friendship groups are like? Do we all go out and just do mysteries and fight monsters? There's a scene where Leo is in this ball and he's supposed to be telling jokes to a number of other characters who are not these guys. And these guys have been laughing at my jokes all week and stuff, so I'm feeling pretty good. I'm like, oh, this is gonna be easy. I started telling some of these jokes and everyone is deadpan. And the director had to come over and be like, okay, everyone, just let's just pretend Harrison is really funny. Appreciate that. But on and off set, I feel like there's always music around.
Yeah.
And that's usually provided by Jojo with his with his speaker.
Outrageous.
I'm scared of a lot of things. I mean, it could be anything like sharks, spiders, the dark. Working on this with a lot of horror elements, I didn't have to act at all. It's just me, and they're like, wow, yeah, great stuff there. You look really scared. I went, yeah, because I'm actually terrified.
I'm terrified of moths. Can't stand them. Can't be near a moth. Heavy flying insects. Vroom, vroom. That's the sound a moth makes. Ah! That's the sound I make.
Although it's super
supernatural, super supernatural, it's still like got a grounding in reality.
There's each sort of villain or sort of scary character, and you can see their sort of arc of getting into that sort of evil villainous stage. And they all have reasons behind it.
And when you see that and you understand it, it's really difficult to be like, oh yeah, they're awful, they're a terrible person. And I think all of the gang, all these characters have flaws. And instead of kind of shying away from them or trying to fix them, they learn to embrace them and try and use it for good. And I think that's a really lovely take on it.
That's a cool message for the show, just to tell everybody to be yourself. You know, don't worry about what people are going to say about you. Just be yourself, man.
Is there a regular in all of us?
Oh, there's an irregular in all of us.
Okay, and enough.